The morning birds wept for thee, Orpheus. The throng of beasts, the flinty rocks, and the trees which had so often gathered to thy songs. Yes, the trees shed their leaves, as if so tearing their hair in grief for thee. They say that the rivers also were swollen with their own tears, and that naiads and dryads alike mourned with disheveled hair and with dark-bordered garments. The poet's limbs lay scattered all around, but his head and lyre, O Hebrus, thou didst receive, and a marvel. While they floated in midstream, the lyre gave forth some mournful notes. Mournfully, the lifeless tongue murmured. Mournfully, the banks replied. And now, borne onward to the sea, they left their native stream. The poet's shade fled beneath the earth and recognized all the places he had seen before, and seeking through the blessed fields, found Eurydice and caught her in his eager arms. Here now, side by side, they walk. Now Orpheus follows her as she proceeds, now goes before her, now may in safety look back upon his Eurydice. The lyre gave forth some mournful notes. Replied. Thank you. recognized all the places he had seen before. Seeking through the blessed fields, found Eurydice.